Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the MongoDB components from within the SSIS Productivity Pack offering. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. Using our MongoDB components, we can facilitate data integration with MongoDB from within SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack offers three MongoDB components: Connection Manager, Source, and Destination. The MongoDB Connection Manager can be used to establish connections with a MongoDB server. The MongoDB Source component can be used to read or retrieve data from MongoDB, whereas the MongoDB Destination component can be used to write or send data to MongoDB. Let's begin by creating our MongoDB Connection Manager. Right-click on the Connection Manager area down below to add a new connection. Select the MongoDB item to add this new Connection Manager. You can add your applicable server as needed. For each server added, the host represents the server containing your MongoDB server. You can also specify the port to your MongoDB server. On the authentication page, you can specify how you'd like to authenticate to your MongoDB deployment. The basic option uses a simple username and password for authentication. The X509 option uses TLS SSL certificate authentication. The next two options are mostly for enterprise deployment using a Kerberos service or LDAP proxy for authentication purposes. In the SSL page, you can configure TLS SSL-related settings if needed. By default, SSL is disabled. When SSL is enabled, you can specify the location of the certificate that will be used. There are two options available. When the store option is selected, the certificate subject allows you to specify the subject of the client certificate from the certificate store. When the file system option is selected, you can provide the path and password to the certificate files to use for authentication. There is also an option to ignore certificate errors. This option can be used to ignore those SSL certificate errors when connecting to MongoDB. Please note, we do not recommend using this option for production purposes. Unless there is a strong reason to believe the connection is secure, such as the network communication is only happening in an internal infrastructure, this option should be left unchecked for best security. In the SSH page, you can enable SSH tunneling by specifying the host address and port number of the SSH server to tunnel through. There are two authentication methods available. When the key option is selected, the component will require a key file to authenticate to the SSH server. The password field represents the passphrase to the key file. When the password authentication method is selected, the password represents the SSH user's password. The advanced page contains all possible settings for a MongoDB connection with applicable description box below. For more details, please visit the MongoDB documentation link provided in our online help manual page. Before we hit OK, we should test the connection to make sure our information is correct and we can connect successfully. Please note that the connection manager that we just created is a package-level connection manager. For SSIS 2012 or later, you can create project-level connection managers if you right-click the connection managers node within the Solution Explorer. Let's begin configuring our data flow task, starting with our MongoDB source component by dragging it to the design surface and double-clicking to open its editor form. As mentioned before, the MongoDB source component is an SSIS data flow pipeline component that can be used to read and retrieve data from MongoDB. Let's select a MongoDB connection manager. The database dropdown shows a list of MongoDB databases available to you. After selecting the database you wish to read from, the collection dropdown will be populated with collections in the selected database. You can choose to set the output as JSON, where all selected fields will be combined into one output column. By enabling the Convert Object ID to String option, this will extract the hexadecimal string from the Object ID method and underscore ID fields. For example, MongoDB will return underscore ID fields in the form of a string literal, such as the following. Enabling this option allows you to get the hexadecimal string, such as the following. There are two options to specify your output time zone, UTC or adjust the local system time zone. You can specify a MongoDB filter string to filter the documents returned from the MongoDB collection selected. To create MongoDB filter strings, you can launch the Advanced Editor. Lastly, there is a Refresh Component button, which causes the component to retrieve an updated list of MongoDB database collections. Let's head to the Columns page, where we can see all available fields from the table specified on the General page. There are buttons available that allow you to add, remove, and move fields in the file. Once you select a field, the Properties window will list some more information, such as name, data type, length, precision, scale, and code page. The Import External Columns option allows you to import the columns and its properties from a file, whereas the Export External Columns option allows you to save the columns and its properties to a JSON file later for reuse. The Documents to Scan to Detect Fields option allows you to specify the number of rows to scan in order to detect the metadata. Click OK to finish configuring the MongoDB source component. For this demonstration, we're going to add a dummy data reader for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to destination component. We can now execute this task. We will now demonstrate sending documents to a MongoDB server using the MongoDB destination component. To configure our upstream source components, we will be using the data spawner component, also available in our SSIS Productivity Pack offering. The data spawner component will help generate some sample data to work with. Let's select a MongoDB Connection Manager. The Database dropdown shows a list of MongoDB databases available to you. After selecting the database you wish to write to, the Collection dropdown will be populated with collections in the selected database. Select the MongoDB collection you wish to write to. There are four available actions: Insert, Replace, Update, and Delete. The Insert action sends new documents to the MongoDB collection. The Replace action replaces entire documents in the MongoDB collection based on the filter string. The Update action updates fields and matching documents in the MongoDB collection based on both the filter string and update string. Lastly, the Delete action deletes matching documents in the MongoDB collection based on the filter string. In today's demo, we will select the Insert action. There is also the option to insert as JSON format. This can be useful when you have already got the JSON document populated. Batch size is the number of documents is sent to MongoDB at a time. This option is only available for the insert action. When the format ID as object ID option is enabled, the value of the underscore ID field will be wrapped with the object ID MongoDB method. There are two options for input time zone: UTC and adjust the local system time zone. We also have a Refresh Component button, where the components will retrieve an updated list of MongoDB database collections. Let's head to the Columns page now, where we can map the columns from upstream components to the MongoDB fields. There are buttons available that allow you to add, remove, and move fields in the JSON document. Once you select a field, the Properties window will list some more information, such as name, data type, length, precision, scale, and code page. The Import External Columns option allows you to import the columns and its properties from a file, whereas the Export External Columns option allows you to save the columns and its properties to a JSON file later for reuse. The Documents to Scan to Detect Fields option allows you to specify the number of rows to scan in order to detect the metadata. The next page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns, error code, error column, and error message. There is also a third option, which is to ignore any errors that may have occurred. There is also the enable columns for default output section, which you can use to enable or disable the additional columns in the destination component's default output. MongoDB response contains the JSON response from MongoDB. MongoDB affected documents contains the number of affected documents after the write action is performed. Click OK to finish configuring the MongoDB destination component. We can now execute this task. This concludes a demonstration of the MongoDB components from within our SSIS Productivity Pack. There are many other components in the SSIS Productivity Pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. MongoDB is just one of the NoSQL technologies that are supported. The Productivity Pack comes with a few other NoSQL supports, including Cassandra and Amazon DynamoDB, and so on. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.